I'm Ericka.
And I'm Kenn.
And we're Dimension the Dot. Thanks for joining us today. So today we're going to do a Goodwill Bins haul. We found some really cool stuff. We thought you guys might like to see it. So,
yeah, if you've been following our channel, we just got done with a big storage unit. And this is our first trip back to the bins. So we were fiending a little bit. I'll go ahead and start with this hat that Ericka found. The brand is Sierra Molinari, and it's just a floppy kind of beach hat here. Nice, because it will be easy to ship. I don't have to worry about protecting the shape. But this sells consistently for about $30, so this brand is a good one to find. Cute.
Okay. Let's see here. Oh, Kenn found a wool rich down vest.
Yeah, this is a goose down, so please go for a little bit more. So yeah, that was a cool find. Another thing I found were these alligator dress shoes. It's a real alligator. The brand is Giancarlo, which is a vintage brand, and it didn't really have pretty much any listings on eBay. However, because these are red alligators, I think we'll still be able to get 30, 40 bucks for them.
Cool. These are a personal buy. But look how cool these are. These are vintage bell bottoms, and look at, they're all embroidered in the bottom with mushrooms. How cool are these? But there's no brand or anything, but I want to keep them for myself because I love them.
And I found some Fox leggings, Fox Moto brand. So these are kind of like snake skin, little print, not too bad. Good brand, Fox.
Okay, I got these Air Jordan
basketball
shorts.
Yeah, those are a good pickup. We usually get about 25, 30 for those. And I normally don't buy this cut of Levi on this
pattern. Those are cool. I forgot about those.
I think they're 514. No, these are 541. So yeah, I've never bought 541s. But these are camo. You can see it's camo jean print, camo denim. So I thought that was really unique. And we're going to give those a blind try. I'm going to try to get for like 20, 25 for these.
Pretty cool. Okay, next up. Oh, a J. Crew 100% lambswool sweater in really good condition. That always sells good. We didn't get too many mind-blowing things. I got one thing and Kenn got something too.
Well, I'll show you my mind-blowing item if we're going to talk about mind-blowing. I mean, I don't know if it's mind-blowing, but it's pretty cool. Okay, so this is a Dyna stereo preamplifier. I think it's from the 1960s. Don't quote me on that. Could be a little bit. Yeah, I would imagine if you take a look.
Okay, let's go.
Dirty. At this bad boy, on the model number sells broken, or you know, four parts on eBay, consistently for over $300. So this is a special little unit. I don't think it's working, but I expect to get about $300 for it in this condition.
Awesome find. And then let's see, these are cute. Kenn found these. These are just some girls. The brand is
Matilda Jane.
Super cute little pants.
Those reminded me of Root, the Avengers character. It looks like a tree. And I don't even watch a whole lot of superhero stuff, but I know Root, and that's what those reminded me of. These are Kohans. Some
shits.
Bread and butter shoes. We usually get 25, 30. These are called the Grand OS. I'm not sure if they're a little better or worse, but typically we get 25 for a used pair of months.
And then I found a pair of older Lucky brand jeans, the dungarees. So those are always good.
And then I found another J. Crew. This one's wool and cashmere. And a nice little cardigan.
I like that cardigan. Okay, let me know in the comments, do you guys ever find pants that are so starched like this? I mean, I...
You could walk away on themselves.
Like, literally, I don't know if you can hear that, but look at me just trying to open the pocket. They're that starched. But these are BKEs, so that's good.
It's common here in Texas. We find those all the time. And you know what? We ship them just like that. And haven't gotten any complaints yet. Here's a Jose Bank Traveler's Collection men's non-wrinkle shirt. So that's probably a good $15 plus ship.
Oh, I found a Lucky Brand linen pearl snap shirt. Which is pretty nice. Double XL. That'll go. That'll sell. It's in really nice shape, too.
I found a pair of FootJoy size large polo shirts. So since they were both the same size, I picked them up and we'll probably get 2 for $30.
And then I found this cute Armani Exchange little t-shirt. Probably go about $15 on that. Super light. I probably didn't even pay 50 cents.
I found a Talbots dress, just like this cool little, I'm not sure what you would call it, it's kind of a unique print, but it's pretty, and probably get close to 20, maybe closer to 15, 18.
Now, I found this, which is kind of interesting, it's a Watt jersey. Now, this guy, from what I've heard, he's just retired. But it's got this patch right here that says 2002 to 2012 right here. So I don't know if he played.
So it's a little older, you know, it's a 2012 version. We find a lot of newer versions, but this one's over a decade old. So we didn't check the comps, but we will check those out. Typically for his jersey, we get somewhere around $20, $25 for it. Maybe we'll get a little bit more. And I found the Apple Bottom jeans. No boots, no fur, but these are cool. Y2K is still inside style from all the young folks at the bins. They tell us. And these are what people are looking for when it comes to Apple bottoms. They want, you know, an actual Apple pocket. So I'm thinking $25, $30 for those. I haven't looked those up in a while because we haven't found them in a while.
What's this?
It's a vintage sweater.
Florence.
Yeah, this is an Italian name. It's Magnificio Florence.
So there's that.
Magnificio. I don't have a very good Italian accent on that.
Oh, I found these cute little 501 cutoffs. And they seem like they're older because the buttonfly.
No, they're all buttonfly 501s.
Oh, they are?
Yeah. That's what makes them 501.
So these are cute.
Ericka got this for personal. It's just a little satchel.
That's really cool, actually.
And I found a couple of these. They're just lights for our light kit. So got those on the cheap. Those will save us some money.
Oh.
Ericka found this weird little...
That's a
webcam, but it's shaped like a dog. It's a dog.
It's so cute.
I want to pet that dog.
Oh, I got these cool pink sweats, really embellished, like with the rhinestones and everything. Hearts, super cute.
Probably get $10 for those.
That's okay.
Ericka found this new inbox remote that I was like, put it back. I don't think that's any good. But for some reason, it sells for like $20. Usually when you get these AT&T or like Comcast cable remotes, they don't sell for much. But this one does, so happy for that.
All right, you guys. I found something really, really cool.
This now is... Cozy needs to do the really cool dance. The really cool dance.
It's a Marciano leather, women's leather, like blazer jacket, but it is from the 1989-1990 collection.
Yeah, it says cheap and chic, so I don't know. Was it cheap back then?
Because it says cheap and cheap.
For some reason, they can't get it open now.
Oh, maybe because it's magnetic? What is going on with this button?
Huh?
Very... Oh, you pull back.
Oh, you pull back. So the inside's all silk. Sorry for that, guys. Look at this. Here's the inside. Now, there's a couple... There's a little bit of staining and stuff on here, but in this condition, $1,000 to $1,500.
Yeah, I saw a similar one online for $1,000 to $1,500. I didn't see any sold, but, you know, it's got the 1989 to 1990 collection, so it's totally vintage. And I'm not very familiar with this designer. Ericka knew who it was right away. But I'm a little bit thrown back when I've noticed that it has this cheap and cheap sort of insignia. So I gotta relook that up. I did see the exact same one up. People were asking for that price, but it was on another site like Posh. But yeah, so if we could get $1,000 for it, that'd be great.
Really awesome.
We'll give you an update.
I will give you an update on that.
It will sell, hopefully, for that price range.
Okay. Well, this is a personal buy. Super cute cashmere sweater.
And I found these sweaters.
Those are interesting.
The brand is Good for Nothing, something we've never found before.
They have a really good sell-through rate, and they sell for about $25.
Very cool.
That's a men's clothing brand, actually. Those aren't women's, those are men's.
Oh, okay. And now we got some linen pants, Jose Bins. Oh, these are actually just shorts.
Shorts. And then I found this. It's called Roland Moret for Banana Republic, and it's a black jacket.
And they had a pretty good sell-through rate on that, too.
We didn't do a big haul today, guys. We've got so much from that.
New Attacks Banana Republic Polo. Can't beat New Attacks. Speaking of New Attacks.
New Attacks Haggard Men's Dress Latch. MSRP is $70. We'll probably get about $20, $25, which is fine.
And then I'll show you a couple of books, and Ericka will show you a couple of purses. And I think we'll wrap it up here. Show them that bad boy.
Oh, this is something I've never even heard of before, and I don't even know how to pronounce the name. It's Montserrat De Luca. I know the last name De Luca, that's for sure. But Montserrat De Luca. Now, this sells for about $45 at a pretty decent sell-through rate, and it's in really great condition. Super nice, all leather.
Yeah, it's very nice.
I've never seen it before, so...
I found this little case full of Xbox 360 games. I don't know any of them are good individually, but I know they will sell in a lot for some decent little money. And hopefully there's a good one in there that we can get at least $10 for by itself.
And then I guess Ken found this. I didn't even know it. The Hawaiian Original.
Oh yeah, that's a good piece.
And this is like a really nice big dress. So... I'm sure that's going to go for good money because this brand sells really well.
And then I found this American Girls Collection Keepsake Edition. And I've sold these before. I think we'll get around $25 for this particular one. I need to relook those up. It's been a long time since I found that. And then I did find one more thing I'll show you. I found some train books. And Norfolk and Western... these two train books. Now, I looked up the first generation diesels, and it has a pretty decent sell-through rate for around $50, $60 on eBay. But I also found the second generation diesel. Haven't looked that up yet, but I'm thinking I'm going to sell them as a pair. And hopefully I get close to $80, $100 for the two. But if you like this kind of content, and you like Goodwill hauls...
A storage unit purchase.
Reveal, storage unit reveal, and just general reselling information. Please give us a like, leave a comment, let us know what you thought was the coolest item that we picked up, and please subscribe to our channel.
Yeah, we'd appreciate it. So we'll see you guys next time. Thank you.